Hello guys, I am Ganesh. Now we are going to continue with the series on Python. In this session, we are going to see the dictionary data type in Python. Before moving ahead, we are going to see the agenda of this session. First, we are going to see what is a dictionary data type in Python. Then we are going to see why can we use a dictionary data type in Python. Then we are going to see the difference between dictionary and list, how dictionary is different from the list. Then we are going to see the implementation of the dictionary in Python. Now first we are going to see what is a dictionary in Python. A dictionary is the collection of data types as similar as the list, tuple and set, but it has the key and value pairs. That means we are going to store the key and value in the dictionary. In the list we are accessing the values by the indexing, but here we are going to access it through a key. So we can give any key and the value to that key. So here are some features of the dictionary. A dictionary is unordered, that means order is not fixed in the dictionary. A dictionary is immutable, that means you can change the values of the dictionary, that means you can update, add or delete the elements. Then it is the index, that means you can access the values by its key. And next part is the no duplicate members, that means we can't use the duplicate key values. We can use the duplicate values, but we can't use the duplicate keys. So let's see why to use the dictionary in Python. So here are the some special features of the dictionary. So the first part is it is unordered and it stores the values like a map. Dictionary contains the key value pairs unlike other data types. Such like in list or tuple, we can't store the values in the key value, but in dictionary we can do the same. It is similar to the real life dictionary with the distinct key values. We had seen the real life dictionary. It has the A to Z alphabets and it has some keys and there is some meaning for that word. So there is the same concept in the dictionary in the Python. There will be a key and we are going to store the single or the multiple values to that key. We can use the nested dictionary, or inside that we can use the list, tuple or set or any data type. Now let's see the difference between the dictionary and the list. So the list is the order and dictionary is the unorder. The older version than the Python 3.7, the dictionary is unorder, but latest versions have the dictionary is order. In the list we are going to access values via index, but in the dictionary we are going to access via key. List is just a collection of elements, but in the dictionary it is the collection of key value pairs. List is preferred when the there is order data, but the dictionary prefer when you have the unique key values. In the dictionary you don't have duplicate members, but in the list you can have the duplicate members. Now let's see how can we implement the dictionary data type in Python. So to declare a dictionary we have to use the curly braces, and inside that we are going to store the key and value pairs. Here you can see key one is the key and we are going to separate the key and value by the colon, and again that there is a value, it is the value of the key one. Here you can use the multiple values inside the list, or you can use the again a nested dictionary. Then there is a comma to separate the two different values. Now let's do some coding part. So I am going to use the Jupyter notebook for the coding part. So here you can see this dictionary is the variable of the dictionary, and we are going to use curly braces to declare the dictionary. So here you can see there is a key value pairs. Here brand is the key and the value of the brand is chord. So here brand is a string, so I had used the double quotes, and model is the key and the value of the model is Mustang, and the year is the key and having the value 1964. In that way we are going to declare the dictionary. So if you print the dictionary, here you can see it had printed the dictionary with the key value pairs. So if you want to access the value from the dictionary. So we have to refer it by the key. If I want to print the brand of a car, then I have to specify the brand in the square bracket. So here I had used the print this dictionary, and in bracket I had used the brand. So it has to print the Ford. So here you can see it had printed the value of the key. So now let's see, can we use the duplicate keys in the dictionary? So here in this dictionary you can see there is a duplicate keys, that means it is a year and it has the different values 1964 and 2020. If I print this, here you can see it had just printed the last updated year. To print the length of the dictionary, you have to use the length function and the name of the variable of the dictionary. So here the length of the dictionary is 3. So here you can see we can use the different data types in the dictionary. So in this dictionary, the name of the variable is this dictionary, and here you can see the value of the brand is the Ford, it is a string. And for key electric, it is the boolean value false, and again there is an integer value for the key year. Again there is a colors in the list, red, white, blue, that are the values in the list that are referred to the colors. Now let's see the type function in the dictionary. So I had specified the dictionary here, and let's print the type of the this dictionary. So here it had printed, it has printed the class dictionary. So this data types I declare is a dictionary. So let's see how can we access the items from the dictionary. So I had used the same dictionary. So I am going to store the value of the model into the X. So I had used the this dictionary. In square bracket I had used the key of the Mustang. If I print X, so here you can see it had printed the Mustang. Now let's see the get method in the dictionary. So here name of the variable is X, and I am declaring it as a this dictionary dot get model. That means it is going to get the value of the model from the dictionary and assign it to the X. If I print the X, here you can see it had a value, it had printed the same value Mustang. Now let's see how can we get the keys from the dictionary. Here we have to just use the X is equal to this dictionary, that means name of the variable of the dictionary dot keys function. It will return the keys from the dictionary. So here dictionary keys are brand, model and year. Now let's see how can we update the dictionary. Here you can see I have the 3 keys and 3 values, brand, model and year. And I am going to get the values of the keys in the X, and I am going to print it here. And again I am adding a new key color and it assigning a value white. And again I am printing the X, that means the keys of the car. So before changing the dictionary, here are the 3 keys, and after changing the dictionary there are 4 keys. So in that way we can add the key values in the dictionary. So we had seen how can we get the keys from the dictionary. Now let's see how can we get the values from the dictionary. So here we have to just use the this dictionary, the name of the variable and dot and the method called as values. Now let's print this. Here the dictionary values are Ford, Mustang and the 1964. So the same thing we are going to do with the values here. The car having the 3 key values, and X having the values of the dictionary, and here we are going to print the car values before changing it. And again we are going to update the year with the 2020, and after that we are going to again print the car values. Now let's run this. So here you can see before changing the car values are Ford, Mustang and 1964, and after changing the or updating the dictionary, the dictionary values are Ford, Mustang and 2020. So in that way we can update the dictionary. So there is another method items. Now let's see what is the items method. I am going to save the values of the items in the x. Now let's print this. So here you can see x having the value dictionary item, that means it is a tuple of the key and the values. So in the first tuple here there is a brand and the third, so it is storing the items in the key value pairs. Now let's see how can we change the values of the dictionary. So here is a brand is a Ford, model is a Mustang, and here is the 1964, but I want to update that year into the 2021. So I have to use the this dictionary, and inside the square bracket I have to specify the key and assign a value that we want to update. Let's print the this dictionary. So here you can see year is updated as the 2021. Let's see the different methods of the update in the dictionary. So I had used the same dictionary, and I am going to use the update method, and inside that we have to use the curly braces, and inside that we have to specify the key and the value pair. Now let's see what is in the this dictionary. So here you can see the value of the year is updated as the 2020. So in that way also we can update the dictionary. Now let's see how can we add the items in the dictionary. We have to just use the name of the variable of the dictionary, and the in the square bracket we have to specify the key and assignment operator and the value that we want to refer to the key in the dictionary. Now let's print this dictionary. So here you can see a new element is added and the key values are color and red. Now let's see how can we remove the items from the dictionary. So I had used the same dictionary, and in that I'm going to delete the model. So here this dictionary and dot pop method I'm going to use, and inside that we have to specify the key that you want to delete, and after that if you print this dictionary, so here you can see there is only two elements, brand and year. Model is deleted from the dictionary. Now we are going to see the pop item method. So the pop item method will delete the item which is lastly inserted. So here it has to delete the year. So let's try this. So here it had deleted the year 1964. Now it has only two elements. Now let's see a clear method. So I am going to use the clear method. Here you can see this dictionary dot clear method, and I am going to print this dictionary. So here it had clear the dictionary, or it has deleted the all the elements from the dictionary. So in that way we can make the any dictionary into empty dictionary. Now let's see how can we copy any dictionary to another variable. So here you can see this dictionary is the name of variable. Inside that we have the three key value pairs. If I want to copy this dictionary into a variable name my dictionary, then I have to just use the my dictionary name of the variable and the assignment operator, and next to that this dictionary is the name of the original dictionary and dot copy method. So let's print the my dictionary. So here you can see it had copied this dictionary into a my dictionary. Now let's see the another method to copy a dictionary. So here this dictionary, and there are three key value pairs, and I'm going to copy this dictionary into my dictionary. So here you have to just use the dictionary. It is a constructor that you want to specify, and inside that the name of the variable. So let's print the my dictionary. So it had successfully copied this dictionary into a my dictionary. So this is for today guys. Thank you so much for watching a video. If you have any doubt or you are getting some error, you can comment in the comment section. I will try to solve it.